Dear students, today I'm going to talk about instrument drivers. As you know, in the freshman lab, every station consists from PC, power supply, DMM, function generator, and oscilloscope. We need these instrument drivers to control the instruments remotely. Now, you can find these instrument drivers from block diagram. Just when you are here, right-click, choose user libraries, here engineering lab libraries, and you can find all of them. Now, what they are? Now, let's start with the power supply instrument driver. Power supply instrument driver, as you know, the electronics power supply is consisted from two boards or have two outputs. Now, this is the first output, this is the second output for the Tektronix, power supply. The first output here, this is the right side, and this board here, this is the left side. Now, for the real power supply, for the real Tektronix power supply, this can supply up to 25, and this can supply up to 25 volts. But the driver itself, now this it can supply up to 25, but the other it can supply up to 6 volt. How to use them? Use them, we need inputs, we need controls, not outputs. Because the power supply, it will supply a voltage for you. It will not measure. The power supply will not measure. That's why we need inputs. Now here, you can come here, right click, create here a control. And here you can put any value, of course, shouldn't exceed 25 volt. For example, you can put any value here, for example, 7 or 6 or whatever, or 20. It shouldn't exceed 25. Now here also you can right click here, create and control another control here. Look here, let me just click here, right click and clean up wire. So here you can put any value, of course, it should be 6 volt and below. Now also, by the way, you can use a constant. It's not necessary to use a control. Look here, if you edit undo wiring, let me just undo control Z, that's it. Now right click here, create here constant, and you can put a value here, for example, 5 or 6, or now here for the second board, the maximum is 6. Look here, and you can put it like this. So you can put any value. So this is a control, and this is a constant. Of course, you can't use indicator. Now, look here to the DMM. DMM, it's different. DMM on the this side, you need input, and on the other side, you need output. Why? Now here in the left side here, DMM function, so you can right click here, create control, so you need input. Now DMM function, it means this DMM will measure what? So if the number here is 0, then the DMM will measure DC volt, if it is 6 period, 5 frequency, 4 ohms, 3 AC current, 2 DC current, 1 AC volt and 0 DC volt. Now also you can, here also you can use constants. You can use constants numbers. Now here the value and unit, you will use indicators because the DMM will measure. So here the value, right click, create, this is indicator, value 1. Okay, you can change the label here and you can put any label that you need. Here on the unit, right click, create indicator, and also unit, you can put any label. Now here the value 1 here, this is indicator, and its color is orange. Okay, because it will measure the measured values, it will be double or it will be numeric. Now this is violet because here it's a string. It's a string, the unit here, it will be string. It will be V for volt, A for current, for example, HZ for hertz, you know, it's like this. That's why it's violet, because this is the type of this indicator is a string. Now look to the function generator instrument driver. Function generator instrument driver is similar to power supply. All of them will be controls, but the difference here, function generator will used for AC signals and the power supply for DC signals. Now, look here, we have four inputs or four what's called boards. Okay, here this is the wave select, this is frequency, this is amplitude, this is offset. Now you will need controls for all of them. Look, right click, create, this is a control, this is for the wave select. Now also here, this is similar to the DMM here, wave select. So zero, you have a sine wave, a six, sync, three, triangle, one, square, zero, sine. Look here, all these values. Now, frequency, here, right click, create, control, this is the frequency. Right click, clean up wire, the amplitude, create the amplitude, control, right click, clean up wire, okay, and the amplitude, be careful, the amplitude, it should be peak to peak voltage, and here the offset, create, control, click here, right click, clean up wire. So here we have the wave select, we have the frequency, amplitude, and offset. So you can choose all the values, and after that you can run the VI. Now look, take a look at the these two instrument drivers. This is oscilloscope meter instrument driver, and this is oscilloscope capacitor instrument driver. And the oscilloscope meter instrument driver is very similar to the DMM function, to the DMM instrument driver itself. In this side, you will need controls, and on the other side, you will need indicators. Look here. Now, this is a measurement type. Measurement type, right-click, create, here a control. Look, let me just put it here, separated. And here, let me just put the function generator in this area. It's better to separate them so you can see them in a better way, a little bit in this side. Yes, that's it. This is the power supply, and this is the DMM. Power supply, DMM, this is function generator, and this is the oscilloscope meter instrument driver. Now here, oscilloscope meter instrument driver, this is the measurement type. So zero for frequency, here two for the period, RMS is five, peak to peak is four, minimum is six, maximum is 7, DC offset is 1, and like this. So for example, if you want to measure the frequency, you need 0 number here. Now the channel here, channel select. If you right click here, this is not that important, and you create a control here. So let me just put it here. So here you can choose the channel. Now channel 1 or 2 or 3 or 4. Here in the Tektronix oscilloscope, we have two channels, not four channels, and you can choose that channel. We didn't use this board usually. Right click, clean up wire. Now auto here, auto, you can choose control. Look here, this is for the auto scale or for the Tektronix oscilloscope auto range. You can use a control. Look here, you can use a control, or you can use a constant Boolean value. Look here, let me show you. Control Z. Here, look, right click, create constant. So this is a constant value. I just want to move it. Look here, this is for the auto. Right click here, clean up wire. So this is, look here, this is true. This is false. For the auto, always will be true. This is a true constant. Now for the value and unit, you need indicators. Create indicator for the value. It's similar to the DMM. And here the unit, create indicator. So here this is the value and this is the unit. This is a double. And this is string is a violet here, the violet color. And of course, the Boolean will be with green color. Now at the end we have the oscilloscope capacitor instrument driver. Here the channel, you can select the channel. This is for the auto. Usually the channel is not that important, So you can create a constant here for the true value for the auto. And this is array output. No need to use it, okay, for our course. And this is the waveform graph. This is the waveform graph. So if you right click here and create now here to display the signal, you will use this instrument driver to display the signal. So the indicator here, it will be the waveform graph. Look here, this is a waveform graph. This is the output. This is the indicator for the waveform graph. Now, when you finish, you can run, but here we have a broken arrow because you can't run them, all of them, in this way. Okay, and by the way, of course, you need to connect your computer to the instruments themselves, electronics. Instruments, they are connected to the computers by USB connection or USB cable. Thank you for listening, and that's all. Thank you.